To say our hospitals are under the pump right now is a gross understatement, and now it's the kids that are bearing the brunt of it. Monday night in Melbourne's Royal Children's Hospital saw staff at called in on their days off as families queued outside in the rain, some for almost 9 hours.
So in the emergency waiting line was Kylie Latu and her 9-month-old baby Emmy, who join us now live in Melbourne. Kylie, thank you so much for joining us. Look, we know that... Oh, hello. What a cutie. Well, can I ask first, how's Emmy now?
Thankfully, she's much better now. Yeah, she's nearly back to her usual self. But, yeah, she wasn't that good on Monday.
Look, take us through Monday, because we heard that she'd been vomiting during the day. The advice you got from the nurse on call was to go straight to emergency. I mean, that's scary advice as it is. When you arrived at emergency, what was it like there?
Yeah, so, as you say, you know, we called nurse on call because I was a bit worried about dehydration, you know, especially with little ears. She wasn't keeping anything down. And when I got there, first thing I noticed was you couldn't even get in. So the line was going outside. There was already, like, nurses going up and down the lines just to get into the triage part. So at the children's, you've got a triage waiting room and then you've got a waiting room in that. So already I knew, you know, it wasn't a normal sort of night. Thankfully, you know, because she's a little one and, you know, even though there were so many people, they were trying to prioritise as much as they could. So they got me into triage as quickly as they could, which was probably about half an hour. And then from there, sorry, she's looking at looking at things. From there, we went into the main waiting room, and probably all up for myself. It was probably about 4 or 5 hours. Thankfully, you know, the medical team were doing what they could, going in and out through the waiting room, checking on the kids, and it was just so busy. And one of the senior doctors came out and let us know that it was probably one of the busiest nights that he'd seen in years. So they ended up setting up like a mini triage so that if anyone had kids that were improving, that maybe could go home. And then they were just trying to put people where they could, even, you know, people getting assessments on the spot in the waiting room, which I've never seen before. You know, I've got three and I've been there in and out over the years. And, so it was very full on.
And look, you feel for all those doctors and nurses doing their best under such trying circumstances. Did it shock you, though, to see how overwhelmed the health system was?
It was... Sorry, she's grabbed. Yeah, she...
we understand.
Loves it. Loves something new. It was, I mean, I knew about it, like, as in I knew that the healthcare system was under the pump, obviously with COVID, and I had been there only a few weeks earlier with my older 6-year-old, but it hadn't been like that. So even though you know, when you see it firsthand, just the extent of, you know, what the doctors and nurses need to do, how under the pump they are every shift, you know. It's incredible how they handled it, what they did, keeping everyone safe. But, you know, you can see it's that breaking point.
And look, and it's really scary if you're turning up at emergency with a sick child and you see lines like that. I know some of the older kids were having to wait up to 9 hours to be seen. I want to bring in emergency physician Dr. Stephen Parnas. Doctor, you know, why are we seeing so many children in our emergency rooms at the moment?
Good morning, Ali and Charles. The reason is that the emergency services are facing the busiest time that any of us have seen in our entire careers. Children have been largely protected for the last couple of years, not just from COVID, but from all viruses because of the isolation measures we've taken, particularly in Melbourne. But now they're all coming back with a vengeance. And so when children are unwell, they're often unwell with two viruses or even more sometimes, and they present with things like dehydration, vomiting, but the one that requires the greatest care is when they're having trouble with their breathing, and everyone is doing the best that they can to try and keep people safe, and that's extremely difficult given the demand that we're facing at the moment.
Yeah, and extremely scary for parents too, particularly when it comes to breathing. So we had Nick Coatsworth on the program late last week, and he was pointing to this sort of new phenomenon where because kids have had this 24 months in some situations not exposed to virus, not exposed to germs, they're catching things easier and just simply their bodies aren't prepared to catch things. I mean, is this likely to play out for much longer?
Well, I think we'll see the worst of it during those colder months where we spend more time inside and we're mixing with other people. And hopefully as things improve, at least in the southern states with weather, we will be less likely to see as many of these. But this is new territory for many of us, so we don't know how long it will play out. We're certainly at, I hope, at or near the peak of this current wave of COVID. Let's hope that those things start to decline, because the impact is absolutely profound on everyone.
Yeah.
I think the word heroic is absolutely appropriate for my colleagues doing what they're doing across the nation.
Yeah. Thank goodness for them, hey. And look, let's hope the warm weather comes soon. Doctor, thanks for your time this morning. And Kylie, we really appreciate you coming on. It's never easy with a 9-month-old, but I'm so glad that Emmy's looking well and that she's on the mend. We appreciate your time this morning. Thanks, guys.